हाय, गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन। मार्डेबल,
हेलो, गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन। टुडे विशाल सर इज नॉट देयर, सो आई एम मॉडरेटिंग इट।
ओके,
सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ क्विक इंट्रोडक्शन राउंड। अभिषेक जनता, प्लीज इंट्रोड्यूस योर।
आवाज आ रहा है मेरा? हेलो,
आवाज
आ रहा
है?
चेहरा नहीं दिख रहा आपका अभिषेक जी।
हेलो, आवाज आ रहा है?
हाँ हाँ, आपका आवाज आ रहा है।
ओके ओके। हेलो, माय सेल्फ अभिषेक कुमार, फाउंडर ऑफ एजेंट।
अभिषेक जी, वी कैन सी यू, वी कांट सी यू। आवाज इतना फीबल है।
ओके ओके, अब सही है?
एकदम फैंटास्टिक, जकास।
मेरा नाम अभिषेक कुमार है, जनता ग्रुप के फाउंडर हैं। बेसिकली मेरा जो बिजनेस है एलईडी लाइट एंड रोबोटिक्स।
नमन, प्लीज इंट्रोड्यूस।
हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज नमन श्याम सुखा। आई एम करेंटली द कंट्री मैनेजर एट लर्निंग वाइल ट्रैवलिंग एंड होप टू सी यू इन द डिस्कशन टुडे। थैंक यू।
अतुल सर, प्लीज इंट्रोड्यूस।
Namaste everyone, my name is Atul Kumar and I am a co-founder of Young Entrepreneurs Network and Ren Ventures based in San Jose, California. Thank you.
Hari sir, please introduce.
Hi, good evening everyone, my name is Hari Kutty and I am working with Holography as a product development manager taking care of Pan India. I belong to Mumbai and I have completed my BE in instrumentation and PhDM in Wellinkers from Wellinkers.
Ujjwal, please introduce.
Yeah, hello everyone, I am Ujjwal Singh and I am pursuing BCom from University of Allahabad and I am a founder and CEO of UAV Law.
Nandan, please introduce yourself.
Hello everyone, my name is Nandan, I am from Hyderabad. I am founder at Precept Pros Education Services Private Limited. Why not bringing the PhD faculties to the schools of 9th, 10th, 11th and 12th is the main concept. Thank you.
Okay, so my name is Sejal Jain and I'm currently working as a country manager in learning while traveling. So today's topic is acquiring startups. So sometimes what happens is when a company acquires the startup, there are like hundreds of points coming into the mind. So we want to discuss about it, that what are the points that a company keeps in mind while acquiring a startup. Let's start with Hari sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir, you are audible. Yes.
So Sejal, could you just repeat the question?
Yes, I'm asking that, while a company take over or acquires a startup, so what are the points that company keeps in mind while acquiring?
Okay, so as far as I know or my knowledge, what I have explored, I see like if the idea is really strong behind the startup and the product is very good, means there is only a lack of funding, then companies, big companies like established companies won't hesitate to take that startup and merge it to their own company and they will just like provide capital to the person founder who has started that company startup. So one of such example may be like Tata Class Edge. So Tata does many supports many startups by providing funding to these small entrepreneurs. So that is that much only I have explored. Rather, I would like to know ideas from other panelists also, other attendants.
Let's ask to Abhishek Janta, what's your point of view on this?
Yes, question repeat.
जब एक कंपनी स्टार्टअप को एक्वायर करती है तो वो क्या क्या पॉइंट्स अपने दिमाग में रख के करती है? This is my question.
First चीज शायद उसके माइंड में आता होगा कि उस स्टार्टअप का फ्यूचर क्या है. अगर हम उसको पैसा लगा रहे हैं तो कम से कम 10x उसका आउटपुट आ सकता है कि नहीं. और ऐसा तो नहीं है कि अभी उसका ट्रेंड है और आने वाला है 1-2 साल बाद वो ख़त्म हो जाए. तो यही सब बेसिक चीज आई थिंक फ्यूचर पे वो ज़्यादा फोकस करता होगा.
Okay, Atul sir, your view on this?
So, एक बार फिर से, I'm sorry, सब लोग फिर से question पूछ रहे हैं. The question again, Sejal.
Sir, जब एक company startup किसी भी startup को acquire करती है, तो वो क्या-क्या चीजें अपने mind में रखती है? क्या-क्या points वो startup में देखती है, तब उसे acquire करती है?
तो स्टार्टअप को अक्वायर करने के पहले सबसे पहले कोई भी कंपनी देखती है कि वो स्टार्टअप आपकी कंपनी के लिए क्या क्या कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री है. मान लीजिए आपके पास कस्टमर बेस बहुत बड़ा है बट रिवेन्यू नहीं है, तो मे बी वो स्टार्टअप के प्रोडक्ट थोड़े प्रॉफिटेबल, मार्जिन ज्यादा है तो स्टार्टअप कॉम्प्लीमेंट कर सकती है. या आपके पास प्रोडक्ट काफी अच्छा है लेकिन सर्विस आपकी मतलब स्ट्रॉन्ग नहीं है, तो आपने किसी स्टार्टअप को ले लिया सर्विस कंपनी, उनका कस्टमर सर्विस काफी स्ट्रॉन्ग है तो वो ले लिया. कोई सर्विस कंपनी प्रोडक्ट कंपनी के साथ को एक्वायर कर लेती है क्योंकि सर्विस के थ्रू उनका रेवेन्यू तो आ रहा है लेकिन प्रोडक्ट कंपनीज का थोड़ा स्केलेबिलिटी ज्यादा होता है, मार्जिन भी ज्यादा होता है, तो सर्विसेज कंपनी क्या करते हैं कि किसी प्रोडक्ट कंपनी को एक्वायर करने देती है. तो कॉम्प्लीमेंटैरिटी इज द नंबर वन. एंड द अदर थिंग इज कि खुद की सेफ्टी, कल को लगता है कि वो कंपनी वो दूसरी कंपनी स्टार्टअप मेरे लिए रिस्क है तो बहुत लोग उस कंपनी को ही एक्वायर कर लेते हैं अगर आपके पास इनफ रेवेन्यू है. और कभी कभी टैलेंट का कॉम्पिटिशन ज्यादा होता है तो उसके लिए क्या बोलते हैं एक्वी हायर, कि मुझे टैलेंट इधर उधर से हायर करने के खोजने के जगह बेस्ट ऑफ बेस्ट टैलेंट को उस स्टार्टअप के टीम काफी स्ट्रांग है तो स्टार्टअप को हायर कर ले तो स्टार्टअप की टीम भी आपको मिल गई. तो दीज आर फ्यू अदर थिंग्स आई कैन थिंक ऑफ.
ओके नंदन, व्हाट्स योर पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू इन दिस?
व्हाट अतुल सर टोल्ड वाज इन डिफरेंट पर्सपेक्टिव बट I'm asking Atul sir that I will tell some views about what Sejal has point of the question as acquiring the startups in the terms of a percentage as in the stakeholder. I think so, like a 5% or 6%. Like take an example, if I am having an interest. Let's say a Bamboo India is a company where the construction of farmhouses are through bamboos. I'm having an interest on that company, acquiring that company in terms of a percentage. Like I'm having some other interest on some other things, like some other will have into aerospace. Like why not acquire aerospace companies and invest them, like we don't have those team, we are having the money, but acquiring those team and in the terms of percentage, their 7% stakehold or those type of stakeholders. I'm asking Atul sir, like what would be the other scenarios of investors? Like what would be their mindset of acquiring this type of companies?
So it's a very long question, Naman. So I sort of got lost in between. But you're saying what would be the stake a company would like to have in a startup? Is that the question?
Yes, sir. While acquiring, if the company, if the person would like the company and want to acquire the company somewhat, or what would it be the stake like in the terms, in that mindset, I'm asking.
So the stake is decided by more of a demand and supply. Who is more? Who needs you more? So if let's say Microsoft just acquired a company. I think almost acquired, not done, TikTok. Now, TikTok is a very, very popular, you know, the Chinese app, which is world famous, billions of users. So now Microsoft will like to see how much value TikTok will have and what benefit Microsoft will get out of it. So what it's getting is all the billions of users of TikTok, they might want to buy TikTok. And then they might want to translate into transition their own app. Microsoft itself has its own instant messaging platform, like Microsoft Teams and Microsoft, always had so many other applications. So they would like to see the synergy. So can they acquire the members of TikTok? That could be one. Or they might say, oh, the technology is so good that we can also use some of the technology within the Microsoft products they have. Or the third thing is some of the teams are the real, I mean, they were not interested in the whole team, but some of the really smartest engineers, that's what they would like to acquire and make part of key Microsoft projects. So different reasons they will, any company, or let's say Microsoft will buy a company like TikTok. And for each of these different reasons, there will be different valuation. So you're buying for users, consumer users, a different valuation. If you're buying for technology, a different valuation. If you're buying for a team, a different valuation. So what is called as acqui-hire. So based on all these three parameters, and these are not the only three, there are many others. Sometimes like risk, trying to make sure that nobody else becomes a threat to them and other stuff. So based on each of these regions they are buying, there will be a separate valuation on these three parameters. And then they will... people who do the valuation, they will do the valuation and they might make an offer to TikTok, and TikTok might have offers from many other startups are trying to buy TikTok. So it's a more of a competitive bidding between different companies which want to buy this startup. I mean, I hope I answered partially.
Sir, yes, sir. Okay. Oh, 1 minute. Sir, 1 minute.
Yeah, Nandan, you can go.
Yeah. Not with the high end, but most of the angel investors, they also acquire so many of the companies as a small stake in small companies, as they keep and target 10 companies or 20 companies in a year. They also acquire so many of those companies, right?
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. So, as far as the angel investing is, let me say, I mean, I've had some experience with that. So what angel investment they do is they know that the company might succeed big time or most likely it will fail. And they are prepared for that high failure rate. So out of 100, let's say 99 or 90% of the companies they will invest will sink, will not succeed. It will not become the next Google or Microsoft or Facebook or IBM. So what they are buying there is taking a risk, expecting a very high reward. And someday out of those 100 companies they have invested in, 100, let's say that 1% companies will succeed big time. So if one of this becomes the next Google or Facebook, then they will compensate for all the losses they would have had from all the other 99% of the investment they have made. So that's what angel investment do. So who will be an angel investor? Angel investors are those who already have enough money. I mean, either it could be a individual person who already made a lot of rich money, like Bill Gates is an angel investor, Mark Zuckerberg is an angel investor. Most of the top successful entrepreneurs, they themselves also invest in startups as angel investors. Or it could be a smaller angel investors, could be some, I have, let's say, Naman has 20,000 rupees and he wants to invest somewhere. And Sezal has 80,000 rupees. So now it's 1 lakh rupees. And then again, between the their friends and family, I gather a few people. So together we can have 1 lakh or sorry, let's say 2 lakh, 3 lakh or whatever the amount invested. And then you will say, we can't buy a TikTok or a Facebook, a big large company. But with our small amount of money, which we have been able to gather as a team and with all your classmates and friends or even parents and family. So with that small capital, you can have a small micro fund. You can involve if any of your classmates is doing or friends is doing a startup, then you guys say, okay, we are the angel investor for you. So that's how many of the angel investors happen, that they invest in the companies or the startup founders they know and trust. So if Sezal has a startup and Naman wants to invest in Sezal's startup because they both know each other, they're colleagues, both are country managers of Learning While Traveling. So Naman invests in Sezal startup or Sezal states in Naman, or together, all of this group, 5 or 10 of you, you can gather. Okay, let's put some fund together. And 10,000 rupiya karke 10 logon invest kiya, 1 lakh ho gaya. So that's how you can raise this angel fund. So that's how funding happens, from my knowledge.
I think I think Atul Sara has brilliantly described what is an angel investor. So coming back to the mergers and acquisitions about the selling and the buying of startups, one more thing I would add in the Atul Sir's point is when there's something like if the company is going bankrupt, some successful company is going bankrupt or has some need of money or they are facing some charges by the law. I could see the same thing happening with the Microsoft and TikTok deal. There's a pressure from the US government to do the deal in at the earliest. So yeah, these are also some of the points where the companies would like to hire, because sometimes there are times that a big company can go bankrupt in no time. So obviously they need some investment or they need some support to continue and go their business. So one point I would like to add this here.
Okay, sure, Naman. Ravi sir, today's topic is that while acquiring a startup, what the company thinks or what are the points in mind of company that the startup he or she is acquiring? What do you think? What points are there in mind of company to acquire a startup? Ravi, sir.
So there are few things which is very prominent. One is the growth which they are looking at. Second, they want to enter into that market, and that could be a supportive, let's say complementary company. Right now, which the case study which we are talking about, Baiju and White, this one. So the basic funda over here is like the new policy came in, education policy came in, so where coding is from 6th class, and this is one of the company which is specially into coding program only for the students. And Baiju, who are very aggressive in the market right now to penetrate education system. So that was like a complementary company. I want to at one side, if I can develop a new segments altogether, enter in that segments, or else I can hire acquire a company which is already there into that segments. So that is one point. And there are other things which happens, like merger strategic alliance happens, acquisitions happens. So all those things are there, but here it is purposefully that complementary of the particular segments which Baiju think to get into. The and one more thing, so you would like the focus area which a company focus on, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
So let's hear it from Unjwal.
Okay.
Ujjwal, are you there? Okay, Aman Raj Basu, your point of view on this?
A little bit later.
So let's jump on to the next question. Sometimes what happens is why the entrepreneurs sell their startup? Is it something that they pre-planned it? Sometimes you grow a baby and sell the baby. What is your point of view on this? Was it sometimes it's pre-planned, or why does entrepreneur sales the startup? Atul sir, let's have your point of view on this.
So Sunil, again, last point was not clear.
I'm asking that entrepreneurs sell their startup. Why? They pre-planned it to grow the startup and sell it. Or why does the entrepreneur sell the startup?
Sure. It's a very important question. Most entrepreneurs don't want to sell their companies. They want to run their company till the rest of life. Not all, but most entrepreneurs. But why entrepreneurs have to sell their companies? Because they feel that, one, the competition is too high and they don't have enough money or revenue to be able to survive or sustain their company. That's one. The other is that they realize that in the competitive market space, if they are part of a larger company, then they can do better. I can take about my example. I have a company, Ren Ventures, and we do a lot of things, consulting and various other things, and also help. I do more spend time on non-profits. But I am in, just now as I'm talking, I've just got a WhatsApp message from one of the larger companies. So they want to have some sort of partnership, and that's what we do. So why I would like to have a partnership with them, or sometime maybe a sale also, because I feel they have something which I don't have. They have products. They have some real products, some IoT devices. They have some everything. I have something which they don't have. They are reaching out to me because I have some relationship with some, let's say, top level CEOs or venture capitalists. So I can, once they partner with me, I bring my investors to them, or I bring my clients to a prospect or clients to them. And what they bring to me, they bring their existing products and platform. They are a much larger product and platform. So then this way, either I sell to them or they sell to me. I mean, this depends on who is the larger balance sheet. So if somebody has a $1 billion company, they will like to buy these $1 million or small companies. But if both of them are large companies, very large, then more likely it was a case of merger and acquisition. It's like Microsoft has bought so many companies, Google has acquired about so many companies. There's the large companies, very large companies, companies like Microsoft and Google, and let's say even Facebook, they are most likely to acquire smaller companies in any industry or any particular geographical segment. So we are very strong in, let's say, America. But when I'm trying to expand into Europe, these other small company, smaller company has a huge presence in Europe or a small presence in Japan. So let's have a partnership with them. So either they will like to buy them, or they like to have a partnership with them. So these are the reasons why companies acquire or get acquired. Did I answer partially?
Hopefully? Yes. Ravi sir, what's your view on this?
So the view is very simple. Entrepreneurs, why they sell company? It's because they grew up the that company to sell it. That is very simple things. Or ek bolte hain ki market mein sab kuch bikta hai. That is what. कि बहुत सारे एंटरप्रेन्योर्स है जो कंपनी खड़ा ही इसलिए करते कि आफ्टर अ टाइम सर्टेन टाइम्स दे कैन एबल टू सेल इट एंड देयर पर्टिकुलर चैनल थ्रू व्हिच दे सेल. जैसे हम लोग
रवि सर के इस पॉइंट पे एक टॉपिक में भूल गया था बोलना चाहता हूं कि आप लोगों ने बहुत लोगों से बोला कि सीरियल एंटरप्रेन्योर, तो सीरियल एंटरप्रेन्योर कौन होते हैं? उन्होंने एक स्टार्टअप किया, ग्रो किया, फिर उन्होंने किसी और को बेच दिया, आईपीओ कर दिया, फिर आगे दूसरी स्टार्ट कर दिया, फिर तीसरी स्टार्ट कर दिया. तो दैट्स व्हाट मेनी सीरियल एंटरप्रेन्योर जो बोलते हैं ना, दैट्स व्हाट दे डू. कंपनी को उन्होंने स्टार्ट करते हैं, ग्रो करते हैं,
और उसकी वैल्यूएशन अच्छी होती है तो बेच देते हैं, फिर उसके बाद दूसरे स्टार्टअप में चले जाते हैं। होपफुली रवि सर यू एग्री।
Elon Musk एक अच्छा एग्जांपल है ये।
And there is particular channel through which this is being done. There are few websites who do it like हम लोग वीसी के बारे में बात करते हैं जहां पे इन्वेस्टमेंट्स आता है। In the same way there are lot of company who are listed to sell themselves into a particular market or into particular segments. तो वैसे भी कंपनीज हैं जिनका जॉब जिनका काम ये है कि वो स्टार्टअप्स को या फिर एक पर्टिकुलर कंपनी को दे कैन एबल टू सेल टू अदर कंपनी।
Hari sir, what's your view on this?
I think Hari sir is not here. We can move on.
Okay.
Yeah.
So Ujwal, are you there?
Yeah. Hi.
Hari sir.
Hi everyone. Yeah.
Yeah, please continue.
Ujjal from this site, yeah.
Yeah.
Continue, continue.
I think, actually I have no comment. I come later, okay?
Okay, yeah. Sure. Hari sir, please continue.
Yes. So, why do startups sell
Sir, we can't hear you clearly, you sir.
Say your voice is lagging.
Yeah, hold on.
While you're waiting for Hari, Abhishek or Faisal, आप लोगों का हेडफोन कौन सा है? बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है।
ओके सर, मेरा रियलमी का है।
मेरा सर JBL का है। JBL का है।
चाइनीज है या देसी?
ना ना JBL पता नहीं, जो भी है। यस मेरा इसलिए
तो हरी सर का वेट कर रहे हैं। हरी सर सॉरी, आई डिडंट वांट टू, आपके वॉइस ब्रेक हो रहा था इसलिए मैं फिल स्पेस।
अभी क्लियर है सर वॉइस?
यस यस
सर,
यस यस,
फर्स्ट क्लास।
ओके सो मैं ये बोल रहा था कि एक्चुअली इसको एनालॉगस ले सकते हैं कि किसी ने एक बछड़ा खरीदा और उसको खिलाया पिलाया बड़ा किया और अल्टीमेटली जब उसका वैल्यू बढ़ गया तो फार्मर ने उसको बेच दिया। सो इट इज द सेम वे स्टार्टअप में जब कोई इन्वेस्ट करता है सो मीन्स स्क्रैच से स्टार्ट होता है वो कंपनी और जैसे जैसे उसका वैल्यूएशन बढ़ता है सो इट स्टार्ट्स क्रिएटिंग कंपटीशन, गिविंग इट गिव्स कंपटीशन टू द एग्जिस्टिंग लाइक कंपनीज इन द सेम फील्ड। जैसे कि व्हाट्सएप और फेसबुक का जो देखेंगे सो व्हेन व्हाट्सएप वाज देयर एंड फेसबुक वाज डिफरेंट so at that time WhatsApp was becoming so popular that Mark Zuckerberg felt like if I don't acquire WhatsApp one day all the Facebook users will get converted to WhatsApp users. So ultimately Mark Zuckerberg ko usko
Instagram as well, just a point
Instagram away. As well, yes. So that is also to add on. So ye ek threat unko pose करने लगता है कि कई ये स्टार्टअप उनको चैलेंज ना कर दे। सो इफ यानी दुश्मनी करोगे तो हो सकता है दोनों में से कोई एक मिट जाए। सो इट्स बेटर कि हाथ मिला लिया जाए और दोनों को मर्ज कर ले। अगर स्टार्टअप को लग रहा है कि उसको अच्छा वैल्यूएशन मिल रहा है सो ही विल डेफिनेटली सेल हिज कंपनी एंड ही विल मर्ज विद द बिगर कंपनी।
ऐसा ही एक केस हुआ है अभी जैसे व्हाइट हैट जूनियर जो आज का केस स्टडी है पर्टिकुलर, बायजूस ने एक्वायर किया है एक बहुत ही अर्ली स्टेज 18 मंथ स्टार्टअप को व्हाइट हैट जूनियर के लिए। तो अब हम लोग थोड़ा अपने टॉपिक में आते हैं, हम लोग अभी थोड़ा फाउंडेशंस के बातें कर लिए हैं। तो व्हाइट हैट जूनियर एक फाउंडेड बाय करण बजाज जो कि पहले डिस्कवरी नेटवर्क्स के ऑफिस चीफ एग्जीक्यूटिव ऑफिसर थे और उन्होंने व्हाइट हैट जूनियर अराउंड $300 मिलियन ऑल कैश ने बायजूस को सेल किया है, तो इसके बारे में अतुल सर का क्या राय है?
तो बायजूस और ये जो व्हाइट हॉट का एक्विजिशन हुआ, तो मैंने ग्रुप में भी शेयर किया था, मेरे कुछ क्लासमेट्स बहुत अमीर हो गए इस एक्विजिशन से. एक तो ऑलरेडी अमीर था, वो वन ऑफ द टॉप वेंचर फंड है, उसका पार्टनर है सिद्धार्थ नौटियाल, तो उसकी कंपनी ने इस इन्वेस्टमेंट में इन्वेस्ट भी किया इस बायजू इस मर्जर में, बायजूस के मर्जर में. और दूसरी कंपनी एक है, क्या नाम बोल रहा हूँ, नितिन, तो नितिन की कंपनी का भी इसमें कुछ इन्वॉल्वमेंट रहा इस एक्विजिशन में. तो मेरा ऐसा बायजूस के बारे में, कमिंग टू द टॉपिक, तो बायजूस के बारे में मेरा ऐसा मानना है कि किसी भी कंपनी स्टार्टअप के हर इंडस्ट्री में वो कोशिश करती है कि वो नंबर वन या नंबर टू है, बाकी कोई रहे नहीं, मतलब कि दे आर द ओनली मुखिया ऑफ द गांव या शेरिफ ऑफ द टाउन, कि नंबर वन रहे और बाकी कोई रहे नहीं. जैसे कल मैंने एग्जांपल दिया पीटर थियल का या और बहुत सारे लोग. तो बायजूस जो है वो एजुकेशन के फील्ड में काफी अच्छा मार्केट उनका है, बट इफ यू सी एट द ग्लोबल लेवल तो बायजूस इज स्टिल अ स्मॉल प्लेयर, स्मॉल प्लेयर. तो अब नाउ दैट उन्होंने ये कंपनी खरीद ली, तो उनके पास फंडिंग थी, तो नाउ थोड़ा सा उनका साइज बड़ा हो गया. अब जो ग्लोबल लेवल पे जो बड़े बड़े एजुकेशन मार्केट में बड़े बड़े प्लेयर्स है, उस मार्केट में भी वो लोग थोड़ा कम्पीट कर सकते हैं, क्योंकि बायजूस का बहुत बड़ा मार्केट है इंडियन मार्केट. इंडियन मार्केट में सबसे ज्यादा उनके पास ट्रैक्शन है, क्लाइंट्स है. तो अगर बायजूस को ग्लोबल जाना है तो उनको थोड़ा सा और बड़ा होना था, तो दैट्स वन रीजन दे माइट हैव बॉट. एंड द अदर थिंग्स कि फाउंडर्स को अच्छा वैल्यूएशन मिलता है, तो दे ऑलवेज रेडी टू बी गेट बॉट और टू गेट डू एन एमएनए. तो मेनली बायजूस जो है, बायजूस जो उसके फाउंडर भी जो है, तो उनको अच्छा वैल्यूएशन मिला, तो उन लोगों ने मतलब उसके फाउंडर नहीं, जिनको उन्होंने खरीदा, वाइट हैट जो भी है. तो फाउंडर्स का जो एक ड्रीम था कि हमको एक अच्छा वैल्यूएशन मिल गया, तो दे गॉट सोल्ड, दे बिकम रिच, एंड बायजूस को भी एक अच्छा कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री प्रोडक्ट मिल गया, और उनका कॉम्पिटिशन भी थोड़ा घट गया, बिकॉज नाउ दे डोंट हैव टू कम्पीट विद दैट कंपनी, नाउ उनका पार्ट बन गया. तो कॉम्पिटिशन को कम करना, अपनी कॉम्पिटेंसीज को बढ़ाना या स्ट्रेंथन करना मार्केट में पोजिशन, और अपने हाँ मतलब साइज को, अपने थोड़ा स्ट्रेंथ को बढ़ाना एक रीजन होता है. और दूसरा है कि साथ में आप जब अक्वायर करते हो कंपनी को, तो कंपनी के जो पुराने कंपनी के जो सारे जो क्लाइंट थे, जो मेंबर्स थे, सब्सक्राइबर थे, वो भी आपके आ गए. जैसे कि यूट्यूब को गूगल ने खरीदा, तो अब गूगल भी अपना वीडियो प्लेटफॉर्म था, बट जब यूट्यूब को गूगल ने खरीद लिया, तो फिर रात दिन अपने प्लेटफॉर्म को सालों तक ग्रो करने की जगह उनको बना बनाया एक प्लेटफॉर्म मिल गया, और यूट्यूब दुनिया का सबसे पॉपुलर वीडियो प्लेटफॉर्म बन गया. तो सिमिलरली एजुकेशन फील्ड में ये बायजूस और इनका जो मर्जर है, वो सिमिलर लाइन पे मेरे ख्याल से जा रहा है कि टुगेदर दे कैन डू मोर एंड दे कैन कम्पीट विद द लार्जर कंपनीज इन द वर्ल्ड बेटर.
अच्छा, तो अभिषेक सर आपका क्या है?
Yes. Whitehead को जिस दिन बायजूस खरीदा था, उस दिन सबसे ज्यादा खुशी हमको मिला था, क्योंकि वो कोडिंग सिखाता है हम बच्चा लोग को. मेरा जो सेकंड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बिमलपुर से वो रोबोटिक्स सिखाता है, तो सपना हमेशा वो बड़ा ही देखना चाहिए. हम भी सोचे थे कि हो सकता है कि 4-5-10 साल बाद मेरे भी एक कंपनी को कोई ऐसा एक खरीदने वाला आ जाए और हम भी अपना एक कंपनी सेल कर सकते हैं. तो एक मोटिवेशन भी मिलता है कि 18 मंथ पुराना कंपनी इतना प्राइस में सेल हो सकता है. तो जब वो कर सकता है तो फिर हम लोग एक नहीं, क्योंकि मेरा भी जो ऑर्गेनाइजेशन है 100+ स्कूल में वर्कशॉप ये सब करवा चुका है, और लगभग बिहार का मतलब मैक्सिमम जो प्राइवेट स्कूल है उसमें एक मेरा ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का ब्रांड है कि यहाँ ये ऑर्गेनाइजेशन रोबोटिक्स सीखना आता है. तो शायद हो सकता है कि हम लोग को भी, मेरे लिए तो उस दिन बहुत ज़्यादा ये मोटिवेशन लगा था कि हाँ और मोटिवेशन के साथ एक काम करना चाहिए. हो सकता है कि अगला व्हाइट हैट मेरा भी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हो सकता है.
रवि सर आपका या सेजल यू कैन गो
रवि सर आपका व्यू क्या है इस पे
अभिषेक जो बोल रहा है वो बहुत ही सही बात बोल रहा है कि व्हेन यू स्टार्ट समथिंग दैट इज व्हाट एक फाउंडर के लिए या फिर एक एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप के लिए सिर्फ यही नहीं होता कि दिस इज वन आइडिया विच आई वांट टू वर्क ऑन मल्टीपल आइडिया पे वर्क करते रहते हैं एंड एक टाइम ऐसा आता है कि जब आपको कुछ आइडियाज जो बहुत हिट कर जाता है एंड पीपल हु आर लुकिंग फॉर इट अभी इसमें बैजू का ज्यादा इन्फ्लुएंस है रेदर देन द वाइट एट जूनियर का क्योंकि बैजू ऑलरेडी एक्विजिशंस में जा रहा है इट्स नॉट बिकॉज कि बैजू को इक्वायर करना है उस मार्केट में जाना है इट्स बिकॉज कि उसके पास फंड बहुत ज्यादा है और फंडिंग का अतुल सर इस पे फोकस करके बता पाएंगे फंडिंग का एक और ये डीमेरिट होता है कि जब आप एक सीड फंड जनरेट करते हैं तो उसको उस टाइम पीरियड में आपको यूज करना ही है अदरवाइज नहीं तो आप नेक्स्ट फंडिंग के लिए नहीं जा सकते हैं विथ दैट टाइम लाइन और फंडिंग में ये होता है कि आपका वैल्यूएशन कंटिन्यूअस बढ़ते ही रहना चाहिए और वो वैल्यूएशन बढ़ता है सिर्फ नेक्स्ट फंडिंग के ऊपर में क्योंकि रेवेन्यू मॉडल उतना सपोर्ट नहीं करता है स्टार्टअप को तो फंडिंग का सबसे वैल्यूएशन बढ़ाने का सबसे इजी तरीका है स्टार्टअप के लिए एंटरप्रेन्योर के लिए ये रहता है कि नेक्स्ट फंडिंग को कॉल करते रहो सो दैट कि आपका वैल्यूएशन ऑटोमेटिक अप जाते रहेगा और बैजू अभी फिलहाल में बहुत ज्यादा कैश बहुत कैश है बैजू के पास में फंड के रिगार्डिंग में इसलिए अभी सिर्फ व्हाइट जूनियर नहीं एक्वायर हुए बैजू ऑलमोस्ट लास्ट 3 to 4 months में 3 to 4 स्टार्टअप्स ऑलरेडी एक्वायर कर चुका और 3-4 ऑलरेडी पाइपलाइन में है एक डाउटनट भी है विच इज इन पाइपलाइन टू गेट एक्वायर्ड अभी बैजू ने यूएस में भी एक स्टार्टअप एक्वायर किया है एजुकेशन फील्ड में अभी व्हाइट हैट जूनियर को एक्वायर किया एंड ओनली द पॉइंट इज कि दे आर लुकिंग टू टेक अप द मार्केट इन ऑल द सेगमेंट्स एंड राइट नाउ इन इंडिया व्हाइट हैट जूनियर वॉज प्रीमियम मार्केट लीडर इन द कोडिंग सेगमेंट्स विच वॉज देयर एंड आफ्टर education policy introductions where it is mentioned coding will be from 6th class so Baiju feel it ki this is the market which will be in future to require me to have it so therefore they acquired a startup rather than starting their own segments aur isme ye bhi rehta hai ki the points I am looking to start, buy somebody the same persons need to be in positions to sell if both things matched together so the acquisitions happens and this is one of the business strategy every company not even Baiju this is the one of the strategy which every company utilize every company do it and it is from the beginning of the business era
Hari sir are you there now
yes
So you're Hello? On networks. Yes, yes. Now you're audible.
Yeah. So, what's the point?
Naman, please repeat. Sir, it's about White Heads Junior acquired by Byju's.
Uh-huh. Right. Yes.
We are discussing about so I think you have understood.
Yeah, go ahead. Please elaborate.
No, I was just repeating that I asked that we are coming to the main discussion point now that why Byju's acquired White Hat Junior, which is a very early stage startup right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the first thing as rightly said by other. Members, Ravi ji, that Byju as of now, and is around just now I saw in online, and seems like it's a startup from Malayali who like Byju Ravindran from Kerala, who is a passer from a Malayalam school. So. Coming to acquisition of White Hat Junior, I think they want it as an add-on. If Byju's itself will start its own coding like segment or coding segment as a separate in Byju's, they will take lots of time, lots of investment, plus. They have to train their manpower, hire new people accordingly. But when coming to White Hat Junior, what is the added advantage they are getting is everything is ready. The meal is served already. You just have to pay the bill and just relish the dishes. So it is the same way. So he acquired, Baijus acquired White Hat Junior, and now coding is like one of the most everyone is having a craze of getting into coding and IT industry. So there is a huge scope. Like it's not that White Hat Junior has said some X amount and Baijus has blindly accepted it and given it. I am sure they have made some marketing strategy based on which they have taken the valuation, and based on that they will be making the profits in future, in future coming days. So this is how every company does, the same way Baijus has done. So that is what I feel like acquiring White Hat Junior will be a strategy for Baijus.
Okay, so Aman Raj Vaso, what's your point of view on this? Aman, are you there? Let's hear it from Nandan. Nandan, what's your point of view on this? Even you are doing startup in education sector, so what's your point of view?
According to my point of view, as Baijus acquired a startup into the coding, it's a point like a small percentage of students only are going to grab the coding skills because they are interested in the coding. If all the students in the India or all the students in the world are into coding, what will happen? It's not in comparison. Only some category of people are only going to make an interest. And I'm making this point in the sense, all the things has to be given to the student in my point of view, not only in the coding skills, but also in so many skills. Yeah.
Okay, I have something to say that Baijus acquired White Hat Junior for $300 million, and it is quite surprising that a 2018 incorporated company has a revenue around $150 million, and this type of scaling is enormous, I would say. And one thing which I am thinking, that what was the main reason why Baijus acquired it? Is it the coding curriculum or the coding thing, or they want to expand in the US? Because White Hat Junior had successfully implemented in the US market, and mostly the students were from US and India. So Baijus also had some plans to expand in the US, and also Mark Zuckerberg, as we all know, invested in Baijus. So obviously I think that Baijus has a plan to, you know, to dominate the US market. Is it that Baijus want to dominate the US market? So I will start with Atul sir. Atul sir, are you there?
Yeah, Naman. So it's not about US market, dominating US market, about the global market. So any company which has an ambition, and most startups have, the ambition is to dominate globally. So obviously, US is one of the top markets in the world, and let's say China is the second one, though it's not that open. So that's why it's harder to for companies to buy or even invest in Chinese companies. So that's why US Baijus thought about US first. And the other thing is, okay, the relationship between Indian entrepreneurs and US entrepreneurs is much closer, because you know many of the top successful entrepreneurs, VCs, they all happen to be from India. So that would have been one of the reasons. I would say globalization, not just US. US is one of the top markets, but then they would be equally open to expanding to Japan or to Europe or wherever they get a chance. But when you are trying to expand, you will focus on a market which is the largest opportunity for you. Like any entrepreneur would focus on the biggest opportunity first. And White Hat being the US based company, so that would have been a good strategic fit for them. But tomorrow you might see that, and as I think Ravijay was saying that them, not Ravijay, whoever, I mean, that they might also be acquiring, they have acquired 3-4 other small scale companies, and they might also acquire, you might see very soon, a European company. They might acquire a company in some other country, let's say Japan or some other big market, because that's where a big market for them is. So it's more about prioritization. So currently number one being US, they first bought a US based company, successful company, because they had the money. And then they might be, there already might be discussions. If any of you Google, you'll find there might be already some discussions on companies outside US also, which they're trying to acquire. The other thing which will, which might come into play outside US is language, because US has English, India has English, but at the moment you want to buy a German company or French company, then you have to also think about the coding training or whatever training they have in that language. So that's why European or other markets are slightly harder, or even Japanese, you need to learn Japanese. So that's why US is a strategic fit. It's easier to do, bigger in size, and easier to collaborate because of the language advantage and many other relationships. The VCs are in huge presence in US, has the largest VCs. The entrepreneurs have also bigger connection in UC in US. So that is the reason why Baiju bought this US based education company, coding company.
Thank you, Atul sir. I very much agree with that points you made. Aman has something to speak. Aman, are you there?
Yeah, hello.
Yeah.
Yeah, thank you for giving chance, Naman, respected my moderator, and all the respected members of our community GD at 10 p.m. I would like to say that that Whitehead Junior का जो अभी हम लोग discuss कर रहे हैं उसका मेरा मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि फर्स्ट चीज ये कि ये हम लोग बात कर रहे हैं कि 18 महीने की कंपनी है, 18 महीने में इतने, मतलब जैसे कि 25 दिन में आपका पैसा डबल हो जाता है, उसी तरह इसका 18 महीने में बहुत ज्यादा पैसा 6 गुना बढ़ गया. ऐसा नहीं है. आई थिंक एंटरप्रेन्योर्स इज मोर अबाउट दैट. उसने काफी सारी रिसर्चेस करी होंगी. आई थिंक मुझे 10 साल, उनको 12 साल लगा हो इस चीज के यहाँ तक पहुंचने के लिए, क्योंकि इतना ज्यादा सक्सेसफुल हो गया. जैसे कि व्हाइट हैट जूनियर की जो फाउंडर एंड सीईओ है मिस्टर करण बजाज, उसके बारे में अभी आप लोगों ने बताया कि इज ऑल्सो द साउथ ईस्ट, जो थे साउथ ईस्ट रीजन के डिस्कवरी चैनल के वो हिट रह चुके हैं. सो इट्स मोर अबाउट एक्सपीरियंस, और वो काफी, आई थिंक वो एक राइटर भी है, उनको राइटर भी जानते हैं, जो कि बेस्ट सेलर राइटर रह चुकी है, उनके ऊपर मूवी बनने वाली है. तो आई थिंक इट्स नॉट ए सिंपल पर्सन who do only simple type of things. He is more about that. His personality is still that how he inspires the people. Second thing is that Baiju ne aisa kyun kiya, kyunki coding ka jo tha pichle 2 saal mein agar dekhi to iska aisa dekhne ko mila hai ki coding ek naya language, jaise ki hindi, english ya fir jitne bhi regional language hote hain, usi tarah coding as global language banne wala hai. Wo har ek aadmi ko sikhna padega. Aisa अगर आप देखिए तो आपको लगेगा कि हर एक आदमी के लिए इम्पोर्टेंट हो चुका है. नॉर्मल आदमी के लिए भी कोडिंग इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट. और इसके रिगार्डिंग बहुत सारे स्टार्टअप्स आई है, लाइक जो अगर मैं बाइजू की कंप्यूटर कंपनीज की बात करूँ, लाइक वेदांतु हुआ, टॉपर हुआ, ऐसी बहुत सारी कंपनीज ने भी, कुछ कंपनी ने स्टार्ट कर दिया है कोडिंग के रिगार्डिंग. तो बाइजू अगर खुद का ऑपरेशन स्टार्ट करता है और फिर उसको अलग अलग डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन भी करता है, तो उसकी खर्चा जो होता है सारी चीजें बच जाएगी अगर वो सीधा वाइट हैट जूनियर में इन्वेस्ट करता है. उसके बाद जैसे इन्वेस्टमेंट मिलने के बाद न्यूज ये भी आई थी कि शायद वो यूके, जर्मनी, ऑस्ट्रेलिया जैसे जो मेन कंट्रीज है वहां पे अपना ऑपरेशन स्टार्ट भी कर सकता है, या फिर स्टार्ट कर भी दिया है वो. तो इस टाइप से काफी ग्रोथ होने के चांसेस और प्रोबेबिलिटी बाइजू के लिए बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ जाती है. वर्ल्ड लेवल पे बात करूँ तो केवल कोडिंग पे ही बहुत सारी कंपनीज आई है लाइक स्किल क्रस, कोड एकेडमी, गूगल कोड यूनिवर्सिटी, अपग्रेड जैसी कंपनी पहले से ही, अपग्रेड तो काफी नाम कर चुकी है अभी, जो कोडिंग जैसे एक स्पेसिफिक कैटेगरी में काफी ग्रोथ कर रही है. और तो उसमें कुछ रीजंस होगा जो जैसे कि हमने बताया कि उनकी एक्सपीरियंस जो है फॉरेन सीईओ और पहले जो जिस तरह से मार्केट कैप्चर अभी कुछ दिनों में जिस तरह से वाइट जूनियर ने कहा है वो वन ऑफ द मेन रीजन हो सकता है कि बायजू ने उसे एक्वायर किया इतने बड़े अमाउंट में.
थैंक यू अमन. रवि सर
ओके
या
सो आई विल पुट द पॉइंट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द बायजू. ओके the main company is Think and Grow private limited from Bangalore. Okay, see right now Mr. Chandran Ravi Chandran, okay, who is into expansion mode completely, and the main strategy which Baiju right now using is to expand in other geography, especially outside India or maybe foreign geography, is through the acquisitions, which is very prominently they are using. See, recently before this they have acquired in US market Oshmo, which we are developing a product for 3 to 6 years of age of students, and they were mainly based on iPhones and iPads, like for the iPhone and iPads users, children. So very premium segments, very niche market, and then particular to the that segments. So he acquired Baiju acquired Oshmos to take care of that age of children. Now again when these things like education policy came in India, and not because of this, the thing is
sir, aapka mic mute ho gaya hai. Ravi sir,
just a minute. Okay.
Haan, okay.
So at present Baiju was not having the segments of coding segments, which is prominently now coming into the markets, and looking at white hat juniors advancement with respect to coding demand and the kind of teachers they had on their platforms and the kind of revenue model which white hat junior was using was a great things to look into. They were paying good to the teachers, and the kind of business models they acquired, like they were giving the educations through online as well as the interactions through offline also, because of which the interactions between a teacher and a students, it was one to one, more of it was one to one. So one teacher will be guided to the one students. So it was that model which followed by Bajaj, and then it got valuations within a 1.5 year, $150 million revenue is a good money to make out of startups. And then Baiju look into it, like when a company into a startup industry, when they start growing up, of course there are people who are looking at the investments, they will keep on their eye to invest on, and the talks starts when they meet at the point, and then acquisitions happen. So this is what the main the focus was more of Baiju on acquisitions rather than white hat juniors of selling their startups, selling their company. And the second point which I tell you, Baiju, whoever company it is getting acquired by Baiju, the company will be run and the organizations will be run in the same name with the same organization setup. Let's say White Hat Junior will be run by Bajaj only. Osmos will be run by Pramod Sharma only. It will not be like Baiju managements will be taking up and then it will be expanding. So like that, this is the way. So this is more of a complete strategic acquisitions to expand the market into their particular segments, to particular geography. That is what Baiju right now doing. So rather than
yes sir, go ahead.
So this is the two kind of a strategy any company follow. Either you need to develop in that segments, or else you buy some company who is already into that segment, or who is already started up something in that segments and going well in the markets. So you acquire them and then you go through it, go like run your business in that segments. So that is what my point is.
Thank you, Ravi sir. Nandan, what do you have to say about the acquisition, about the point which I made?
Can you please repeat the point of what you make?
What I said is that what is the main reason why Baiju's acquired White Hat Junior? Is it to expand in global markets, especially in the US? Or
as Ravi sir told, the Baiju's is upon MBA, IAS and different other streams upon where the degree people or after degree people or who are studying into degree, they are going to study, but they are not into technology. I think the Baijus are into the mindset of acquiring the world, acquiring the other countries, people also are not only into by acquiring this as a technology, they want to implement this Baijus over their countries. This could be a great opportunity as an a marketing has done, as a business was made, as Baijus is known as an Mark Zuckerberg has invested in it. It would be a nice opportunity for the Baijus to acquire other countries also.
So it is like double bonus. You will also get some markets and yes. You will get the technology curriculum right away.
Yes. Yes.
So Abhishek sir, coming to you.
मेरा कहना यह है कि बैजू को एक्वायर करने का मेरे को जो रीजन लग रहा है वो जो कोडिंग सिखा रहा था व्हाइट हैट, तो आने वाले इस समय में जिस तरह जब हिंदुस्तान में कंप्यूटर आया था तो उस समय लोगों को लग नहीं पाया था कि एक समय में स्कूल में कॉलेज में एक कंपल्सन हो जाएगा, हर किसी को लगता था आ गया तो आ गया, सारे लोग के पास नहीं पहुंच पाएगा। उसी तरह आज के समय में आने वाला 2-4-5 साल बाद 10 साल बाद सारे लोगों को कोडिंग हो गया या एक टेक्निकल नॉलेज हो गया, वो उस स्ट्रीम के नहीं भी हैं, फिर भी उन लोगों को थोड़ा बहुत शायद सीखना पड़ सकता है। इसका हम अपना बेस्ट एग्जाम्पल देते हैं कि मेरा जो कंपनी है रोबोटिक्स का बिमल बुक्स, बहुत ही छोटा है, बहुत ही कम लोग उसका मतलब बिहार के बाहर जानते होंगे लोग, लेकिन टेक्नोलॉजी का ट्रेंड क्या है कि हम अपना 6% 6 आदमी को अपना फ्रेंचाइजी उड़ीसा के आदमी से सेल किए, एक आदमी से हम 75,000 चार्ज किए और मेरा जो कॉस्टिंग था उसमें 4,000-5,000 रुपया था, और जो मेरा फ्रेंचाइजी लिया था वो सारे लोग 35+ एज ग्रुप के थे, तो मतलब 35+ एज ग्रुप के हैं और उनको भी एहसास हो गया है कि आने वाले समय में इसका फील्ड है, टेक्नोलॉजी से हम भी दूर नहीं रह सकते हैं। अगर हम सीख लेते हैं, हम भी स्कूल या कॉलेज में जाकर सिखाएंगे तो इससे हम पैसा अर्न कर सकते हैं। तो मेरा कहना यही है कि उसका एक्वायर करने का मेन रीजन यही हो सकता है कि मतलब कोडिंग बोलिए या टेक्निकल फील्ड से जुड़ना है, क्योंकि आने वाले इस समय में हर किसी को टेक्निकल नॉलेज थोड़ा बहुत शायद लेना ही पड़ेगा।
Thank you, Abhishek. So let's jump on to the next question. Charles Neck theory, the survival of the fittest, that only strong companies survive. But sometimes the acquisitions are not fit and they fail. So what can be the main reasons that an acquisition fails? Atul sir, your view on this. Why does an acquisition fail?
So acquisitions fail often because of lack of clarity on expectations from each other, that what the company which is being acquired is expecting and what the company which is acquired is expecting. Sometimes there is expectation mismatch. So the other thing is the founders also. One is the company, and the company basically represents the founders represent the company the best. So the founders are different personality types, different goals in life, ambition in life. Somebody wants to sell their company, as Ravi was telling earlier, that some companies have started to sell. So I would like to sell the company in 3 years or 5 years, whatever, when they get the right valuation. Whereas some of the founders might have a vision that I would like to run this country for a company for 10 year, 20 year. For some companies, profit making is the only thing. They want to be the most profitable company in the world. Whereas for other, the company might be, no, we want to have a maximum impact on the society, a positive social impact on the society. So when the company founders, as well as the companies, their values, their goals, ambitions, they're not aligned, that's when this mergers go bad, this relationship. Because it's like a marriage. So a marriage is an easier example to explain. So when a girlfriend and a boyfriend, they start dating each other. So some people make the decision very fast and they immediately get married and live happily ever after. It doesn't happen that way. More often than not, if you have not given enough time to understand each other, personalities, each other, priorities, then you will get in a lot of trouble immediately, even during the honeymoon or after marriage. So a similar thing with startups. So if startups have given enough time for dating and they have started given enough time to making their parents also meet each other. Sometimes even VCs are like parents. So whoever the investors, so if they also have to have an alignment, what the goal of the VC which is funding startup A versus the VC which is starting a startup A, and they're not one VC, multiple investor. So if their priorities, ambitions match, then the relationship will go fine. Because even if there's some trouble, then the parents in the room, the investors or the advisory board, they will intervene and they will try to make things go right. But in case they have not involved the parents and they have not involved the family, and I'm talking about the startup, not in a marriage sense, then if something things go wrong, there's some conflict, differences of priorities or different of strategy, then there's not somebody who can come and play the beach bachao, somebody to who the solve the relationship issues. So startups are also like human beings. If they have a relationship issue, so they need help of friends and family to make things right. Hopefully I answered it.
Yes, Atul sir, answer pe humko kehna hai ki jaise aap batla rahe the, iska acquisition if fail hone ka ek reason mere ko aur bhi bada lagta hai. कि जैसे आपका एक कंपनी है एडरेन वेंचर्स, हम अपना फर्स्ट कंपनी स्टार्ट किए थे जनता ग्रुप, तो जो आदमी उसको ये स्टार्ट करता है, फाउंडिंग मेंबर रहता है, वो उसका तकलीफ बोलिए, दर्द बोलिए या लगाव बोलिए, बहुत ज़्यादा अच्छा से समझ पाता है, क्योंकि उसका वो रिलेशन लॉन्ग टर्म का होता है, क्योंकि उसको जीरो से लेकर वहाँ तक पहुंचाया रहता है, और जो भी बैजू इक्वायर किया है तो बैजू का फर्स्ट फोकस ई लर्निंग जो उसका अपना है उस पे रहेगा, सेकंड प्रायोरिटी ही इसको देगा. तो ये जरूरी नहीं है कि जिस प्रोग्रेस से अभी व्हाइट हेड ग्रो कर रहा था, हो सकता है कि उसका डाउनफॉल भी आ जाए. जो उसका ये एक्सपेक्टेशन, जिस एक्सपेक्टेशन के साथ वो बाय किया है, वो शायद उसका फुलफिल भी नहीं हो सकता है, क्योंकि मेरे ख्याल से उसका फर्स्ट प्रायोरिटी बैजू रहेगा जो अभी चलाता है. लेकिन जो व्हाइट हेड का फाउंडर था, उसका फर्स्ट प्रायोरिटी उसका वही कंपनी था.
ओके, सो लेट्स हियर इट from Ravi Kumar, sir.
See, my point in acquisitions is it's just an strategy which a company decide to do for, okay. That will work out in favor, that will not work out in favor. There is a lot of reasons, like very subjective. We cannot generalize it, ki why it has not worked. Because when cases fails, then we do the analysis and understand ki why it has failed. And when the cases become successful, then also we do the analysis and read about ki why it has been successful. So, but the prominent things which basically happens with the strategic acquisitions is 2 or 3. One, a very good company who wants to enter into a new geography. So that is one thing. He always look for a company who is already there into that segment and who is doing good. So rather than putting up the complete setup, he will take up the existing company with the investments of money, and then he can get the company running into that segments. One, second, sometimes it also happens when, let's say, Baiju is expanding into different geography with different name. So let's say if tomorrow that company which is acquired got failed, then also it will not hamper as a name of Baiju. So the company main company name will be remain intact. There will be no issue with the brand itself, but the other brands which is connected with the Baiju, maybe that will be failing. So that will not impact the Baiju as a brand. So that is also keep people while acquisitions in mind. Third things is like there are few companies who are particular to the product. Let's say I'm into the same segments, but I have few products which I want to launch in that market. Let's say to be very frank and to make it at a lower side, I'll tell you, let's say tomorrow, I from Bangalore decided to invest in Bihar and in a segments, let's say the robotics educations I want to invest into. So rather than I'm putting my team opening a company over there, I can think of acquiring Abhishek business and say, Abhishek, I have an offer for you. Would you like to come and sit on the table and discuss the things, so that this is my investment plan and I want to looking to operate in Bihar and I can operate through you, and then we can make acquisitions in that way. That is also possible. Steps one to take off, or else I can go ahead and do the investments in Bihar. I will register a company, I will hire the people, and then I will start from scratch, zero. I will start interacting with the schools and set up the things, and then things will go out. Let's say 6 months or 8 months, my product will roll out into the market in that way, and the revenue will be started. So that is why if I have a money to acquire that company, if things goes well, rather than putting up the new setups, I will acquire a company and then I will run the business. So these are the strategies basically being used. But at the same times, it will be right or wrong. It depends on the further business which takes place. Let's say tomorrow after acquisitions, Abhishek told, no, I will only be running the company. That is the conditions. Like that is the conditions to do get into involved. I will be running the company. So in the beginning, I accepted it. And then in later point of time, when company started, Abhishek started running the company, he would not be connected with that well with the company because it is no more his company. So he will give less focus. And at the same time, I will not be aware of sitting at Bangalore ki company focus is not that much from Abhishek's side. So what I will do, I may hire some CEO and then I will replace him with some CEO. So that may fit into the segments, like the new joining CEO may take the business in that particular way or may not be, because sometimes it happens like the persons who is running that company, he is more known to the company and clients associated with that particular company is due to that person name, or may dissociate when that person names moves out from the company. So that one becomes the chances of failure. But that is why I'm saying failure always is a very subjective company to company. If I put at larger specs, few companies name, let's say Coca-Cola, when came to India in 70s, they acquired the company Thumbs Up. It's all because Thumbs Up was the only drink in India, carbonated drink in India, which was accepted at mass. And the taste was very particular to the Indian consumer taste. So when Coca-Cola came in, they were not able to sell the Coca-Cola, though they were market leader in the world. Then they acquired the Thumbs Up and they tried to suppress the Thumbs Up and try to distribute more of Coca-Cola. But still, you know, Thumbs Up is there in the market because those who drink Thumbs Up, they will take Thumbs Up only rather than Coca-Cola. Same case with Cadbury. When Mondelez tried to come into Indian market and introduce Oreo, they felt a lot of competition because Oreo was a biscuit for Indian market. And in Indian market, people do take biscuits, like consumer behavior towards taking up biscuits is different in Indian market. Whereas in US, Oreo play a vital role in terms of consumptions. Oreo is not being consumed as a biscuits only, but there are other byproducts which is made out of Oreo, cake, milkshake, and all those products which is like byproducts of the mixing of Oreo. It is there. Whereas this behavior was not there of Indian consumers. So what they did, they take Cadbury and then they introduced Oreo, but still both the company remain intact and run both the product at the same time, Oreo and Cadbury. So that is what this happens. Now Reliance, same case of Reliance Jio. Jio is also acquiring a lot of company right now in India, small startup companies, to put that company into portfolio of Jio. So if a company
JioSaavn.
A lot of company, not only JioSaavn.
Internet,
yes, in industry, entertainment industry, they,
e-commerce sector.
Yes, so all the segments they are acquiring the company just to make themselves, because they have money, so they can think of that strategy. That's all.
Okay, thank you, Ravi sir. Let's hear it from Nandan.
No, I don't have any.
Okay, let me put a question. Let's say, see, all the people who are right now young, they are more of into coming up with either their startup ideas or their product development stage, or maybe going to start something. So what is your take in terms of, let's say you are developing a company, do you feel like selling is a propositions, or continuing with it is a propositions, or doing both is a proposition?
Let's hear this from Naman.
Yeah. So there are two things I would say that depends here. One thing is, like, if there's some long-term goals, suppose a company, a manufacturing company or an educational company, I can see the vision far away, like 10 years from now, and I can see it grow very well. So I would not sell the company because I have that vision and I have that thing to do. But there are sometimes there's a mind of serial entrepreneur where it comes to play. Yes, there are so many serial entrepreneurs which we see. They mostly, what they do is like Elon Musk, what he did. He invented PayPal. He sold it to eBay. He moved on to do some greater projects which he wanted to do. So what I think is, some, if I have a greater project, I have so many projects in mind and I have selected 2-3 projects which I want to do. I'm just placing myself in the shoes of Elon Musk, suppose. So I have a dream that one day people will live in Mars. One day I'll be there in space. So I don't have the capital to start immediately SpaceX. I would not be able to, because I don't have that many, investors. I don't have any team members. I don't have any capital. The main thing is capital here. What I did is I wanted to experiment with other things, other instruments, so that I can be very much confident in the entrepreneurship world and startup world. And I can ensure that the next time if I start the company or the another company, if I start, it will be much more faster than the previous company which I built. Or I want to have some capital. I have some long-term goals in different sector and I want to sell that company. That's my mindset here.
Okay, Aman, what's your view on this? Aman, are you there? Okay, let's hear it from Nandan. Nandan, your point of view on this.
You asked me regarding?
Regarding Ravi sir's question. Like, what do you prefer, selling your startup or what? You are starting a startup. So what will be your proposition or your preference?
I'm sorry, I have just came. I didn't listen to the Ravi's question. Can you please repeat the thing?
Okay, my question is, Nandan, yes, like, sir, let's say all the young minds who are there in the discussions, all are into either going to start a startups or already started the ideation phase, or maybe going to start a company altogether. Okay, so my point is, what is your take in terms of developing the startups and selling it, one. Second, to grow it with own intensity and make it long run. Third, either to grow it and then sell it, both compositions.
Sir, in my point of view, right now, as we are into this age, as we are into beginning, developing a startup would be a great opportunity for us to develop other startups. Like if I take an example, taking all the eggs into one tray in a cycle is more dangerous, like taking separate eggs into nine different cycles would make more difference. Like if 4 to 5 cycles would damage or make an accident, other 5 would be safe for us. It would be my idea as developing an startup and selling the startup, by that money we can invest it into other startups. I want to ask one thing also. As serial entrepreneurship thought was came, what was the percentage of serial entrepreneur? As they sell the startups, they are into other startups, or they are ending their life and enjoying their life? I want to keep this question also.
So to be very specific, Nandan, this is a questions which we all have answer. I'll put it in this way. See, what do you think entrepreneurship is, a journey or a destination?
It is a journey, sir. Is a journey.
It's a journey. So journey do not have destinations, as you know, right?
Yes.
So till the time you consider entrepreneurship as a journey, it will not end.
Yes.
So it might change the nodes. Like when you be in the journey, there would be some small distance destinations where you might restrict yourselves to a particular things, and then you get to another, and then you get to another, that get to another. So the persons who came into entrepreneur's journey, he will not be going back one to the job site. In most of the cases.
Yes.
So what he do? He do not have an options like an employee to change his job. So what he do, he change either he start working on some other idea, he change the company itself, or he might change the segments of the work itself. Let's say today you are working in education systems. Tomorrow you come with a network where you got a chance to work with automobile segments. So you may start something in that segments, or maybe after 3-4 years coming the lines, ML and AI will be very prominent in the markets or high demand. So then your mind of share might attract your mind to invest into that segment. So then you will start maybe a company into AI or ML, or maybe day after tomorrow you felt like the supply chain into by the drones are very prominent. Now I can start up in this segment. So maybe you may think of starting some things into that division. So this is how an entrepreneurship journey goes by. Once you started on the journey, will start from up. Idea. That is why in the before 3-4 discussions we had this question: shall an entrepreneur should release his idea after a time, or should he restrict with the idea? That was the questions asked by Vishal. How soon a startup should realize to I am failing with the idea, and should I start another one? Yes. So the basically question come for the pivoting.
Yes, failing would be another prospective, and this is an a success prospective. As a success company, it's selling to another and doing another company.
See, in this case, in White Jar or any acquisitions which happens, okay, so one at least they fail to continue with that idea, right? Then only the acquisitions happen. If I am ready to sell my product, so that I am failing to not to continue with it.
Correct. Yes.
And this is what happens with everybody. Let's say 1 year ago, the Flipkart was acquired by Walmart. So when Walmart decided to come into Indian market with online segments, they look for a company who can give that mileage rather than starting up a new fresh account of a new company and then getting into the market. So they started talking with the Flipkart to acquire, where both the founders Binnie Bansal and Sachin Bansal agreed to sell their company. So they sold it to the Walmart. But again, they have invested in some other company right now. They are also into education segments. They're into EV segments. They're also into.
So there's another angle, Raviji, on the Walmart acquisition of Flipkart, that many countries have been trying to restrict
any entrepreneur startups about who owns the company. And so the reason why, like retail, every country has some restriction on foreign investment. So India also made those restrictions. So that's why for Walmart, it would have been hard to get into the Indian market. The Indian regulators were not allowing them to. So then for them, the easier way was to just buy Flipkart, and they got entry into Indian market. Even though Flipkart started by the Bansals and Indian origin and owned by mostly Chinese investors. But the reason was also to get entry into Indian market, where Walmart would have found hard to get into because of all the pressure from the trade bodies, industry bodies, all the retailers and shopkeepers and everything else would have united against Walmart. So they got entry through backdoor through buying Flipkart. So mm-hmm. Flipkart is also a half Chinese, half American, but since founders are Indian, so they could more easily get this Walmart entry to Indian market. That's one of perspective I have.
Mm-hmm. I think Atul sir, I also pointed about that because of the laws and the regulations in certain countries restrict to for the investment or something like that, which has happened with the TikTok, which we see recently right now, has been there. And one more question was there in my mind. Once I was there in attending a lecture of IIM Calcutta, one of the professors and the chief advisors there, Chandradeep Mitra, he is the professor of marketing. He said that marketing is number one, and every startup or every company has to have a voice. Otherwise, there will be a disaster. So one thing is there, which I have seen right now, there's a trend in the mergers and acquisitions. We say about the mergers and acquisitions, but they are two different terms. Okay, so now companies want to acquire companies, not merge their companies. Okay, so what's the reason behind it? I will start with Atul sir. Yeah, you want to say something, sir?
So what you're asking, Naman, is that why do companies acquire companies rather than merging the company?
Yes, or, yeah, that's my point.
So it's all about control. So I'll bring another example, slightly non-business example. It's like marriage. So when two people get married, it's like a merger of a company, one family and another family, or it could be acquisition too. So why acquisition? Like one family is very dominant, very, let's say, rich or powerful or whatever, be it a girl's family or guy's family. So they will dictate the terms and everything else. They will decide ki who will live here and how will the marriage, everything else happen. Whereas both parties have the equal footing, relationship on equal footing. Both are respectful for each other, then that's more like a merger. So, but if not, it can be an acquisition because one family, the rich family or the powerful family, acquiring the other family. So, so that is the easier way to understand how in the merger acquisition and mergers and acquisitions, what are the difference between them and why it happens. So if you think from a human psychology perspective, the same thing even applies in business. Think of company as a human, and a startup as one human, and the other company, the acquired company, is another human. So two humans getting into relationships. Now, what type of relationship they want to get into? So that will depend on the strength and personalities of those two. So how much power they want to have. Companies also want power, and individuals also want to have power. So a little bit of power game playing on. Who wants to have more power, more control? And also it's like equal relationships, or one side is more powerful, the other side is less powerful. So these are sort of things happen in companies as well as individual families. I'm giving the human example. It's easier to understand for more. Many of the people here in the younger lot, they might not have run a company or they might not have a big company experience, but they can relate to it. How this equation happens. They can relate to a family example and try to relate that with the startup and a company example. There's a lot of similarities.
Thank you, Atul sir. Now we'll come to Ravi sir. Do you have something to say, Ravi sir?
See, merger and acquisitions both are similar, but the ownership which affects at large. Okay, the strategy remains the same. Only acquisitions give you the ownership of the company. Okay, you become the owner of that company. Whereas in merger, the shares of the percentage of the shares will have an effect. But mergers, the basic principle for mergers to happen is to have either a strategic alliance or maybe two company with different orientations, they are collaborating together to cater a particular market or particular segments of product. Let's say, see, there are a lot of mergers. And third things, mergers initiated due to the laws also. Like before 1991, when India do not had permissions of FDI, a lot of the foreign company do come into India through the mergers only. And they continue with, let's say, Tata had a lot of mergers with a lot of foreign company into different segments. Starbucks right now is still in merger with Tata. Then Tata Docomo came in with mergers to take care of the telecom segments. Airplane industry also, that airline industry also comes with a lot of mergers together. Right now, Tata did merger with one of the company from Saudi Arabia. So that is what, in acquisitions, it is completely to take care of the ownerships. I want to have 100% ownership of the company, so I will acquire the company. Mergers moves with three more prominent things. One, maybe a law do not permitting me to enter completely. So one, second, could be two different skill sets of particular company and they want to group together to work for, to cater particular segments of the markets as a large. Or third could be strategic. Let's say I am a company who is into labor intensive or the company who is into technical things. We both can merge together and can develop a product which will be accepted to the markets and we can rule out that product into the market.
Thank you, Ravi sir. I think we have exhausted our time for the GD at 10. It's around 11:30 right now. So any last comments or ending comments? Anyone?
Not anything from my side.
Okay. So thank you all for today's GD. It was very much interesting one. And Ravi sir and everyone, Atul sir, everyone has made some good points. And there was such a great example of Baidu's acquire Y10 Junior today. So thank you everyone for attending this GD. And good night. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you everyone.
Sejal, please.